So I'm assuming everybody can see my screen now. All right. Sorry about that. Too many buttons on here to push. So right now I'm on Western Power Sports. I'm going to come over here to the supplier info. Let me get this thing out of my way. So we're going to go right here to supplier info, and this opens up our control where you set all your defaults for each of your suppliers. Up here in the top left, you'll see export PO using. And if I open this, you'll see there is a Western Power Sports here that you most likely are using currently. And it is what provides you with a file that you can export and upload to their web portal. You'll also notice that some of these say Western Power Sports web interface, and you got Tuckeraki and Tuckeraki web interface. If you go up here, Polaris and BRP are a little bit different, but with Tuckeraki and Western Power Sports, you have the ability to select that they are web interfaces. What will happen at that point is once you select that it's a web interface, you'll scroll down a little bit and you'll get information. Actually, I went too far. You see right here, it says API key. And so what is going to happen, and this is kind of the unfortunate thing, is that you're going to have to contact each of these suppliers. So right now we're talking about Tuckeraki and Power and Western. You'll need to contact each one of them, tell them that you're using Lizzy and that you want to use their web interface, the API, to upload orders instead of doing it through their web portal. They'll, in the case of Western Power Sports, they're going to give you an API key. In the case of Tuckeraki, there's a little bit different process that you go through, but they're going to give you some information that you're going to fill out on this screen. So this screen is going to ask you for whatever it needs for whatever interface you're working with. So this changes based on who you select. So right now we've got the API key filled in here for Western Power Sports. And we've got it set to do the web interface. So at that point, when you go into any of the invoices, so I'm just going to jump over here to an invoice that I started before we got started here. I'm going to add a part. I want to tell it I want to look at Western Power Sports. Let's see. So we're going to go down here to Western Power Sports. I'm just going to pick a part. In fact, let's just put in, and we'll pick a fuel thing. And so you'll notice that you have this availability link over here. There's a couple things about this availability link that I want to point out, other than the fact that Rustin just broke my He was tweaking something a minute ago and just broke my control. But hopefully he'll get it fixed here in a second. So what happens on this control is, one, the system, if it has a web API set up with that vendor, it's actually going to query that vendor and find out what the current pricing is on that part, whether there's any supersession data on that part, what the availability is. In other words, which warehouses have that part in stock, so that you can kind of get an idea of where they're going to be shipped from, and how many days it's going to take to get there. So there's quite a bit of information available that comes back on this control. Now, in addition to that, and this is kind of generic whether you're using one of these interfaces or not, you've also got information in here whether you have that part currently on an open service ticket or whether it's on an internal ticket for a unit. So the idea here is that if you have the part anywhere in your dealership and you really want to get that customer taken care of, it's letting you know where all of those parts are located. Let me see if he's gotten this thing fixed yet. And that would be a no. So I'm going to go through a couple other things while he's looking at it. So the next step is we go in, we check our availability. We see that we're going to be having to order it. It's going to be coming from California. It's going to be 4 days before, 5 days before it's going to get here. So I can give the customer all of that information up front, instead of having to wait and have them continuously call me up trying to find out when their parts are in. Now, when I put the part on a ticket and I end up ordering it, when we go over here to accounting and go to our payables, and I'm just going to look up Let's see. Let me look up a parts order for Western. I don't know if I actually already have one in here or not. There's Western Power Sports. So here is a new order that we have for Western Power Sports. Now, what is going to happen is, anybody that's in the parts department knows, we're going to go in and edit the purchase order. We're going to go over to our totals page, and then we're going to tell it to place the order. Now, when I place this order, let me see if this, is a special order. So when I place this order now, I get this same export order button that we normally would get when we're exporting a file. But what's going to happen at this point is it's going to actually send, and I'm not going to click it here because I'm in a demo, but Okay. But this is going to actually send the order. So now instead of having to open it, download it, log in, upload it, check it, all that kind of stuff, I'm literally just going to click this export order button, the link, and it's going to send the order off to Tucker or Western or whoever it is that we're looking at. Now, in addition to that, once that part gets ordered, and I'm going to look at this ordered. So once that item gets ordered, you'll notice that there's an order status button that shows up at that point. What this button will do is when you click this button, it will go out and communicate with whoever the vendor is that it's working with, check the order status of that order. If the order has already been shipped out, it will grab tracking numbers. It will grab box numbers. So you'll know that you've got three boxes coming from three different warehouses, and, everything available to you that Tucker or Western happens to know about that order, it'll pull that in and display it for you. Now, in addition to displaying it here, it will also make that information available to you on the special order list so that you can go over to the special order list. And when you click the open up the, details on the purchase order, it will actually give you all of the information about tracking numbers and all that kind of stuff as well. So everything that it pulls in from the purchase order gets displayed everywhere else. Now, right now, Tucker Rocky and Western Power Sports are the only two vendors that have this level of communication. BRP is another vendor that has close to this, but they have the ability to place the order, but they don't have the ability yet for you to get updated order statuses like this. We're working with Polaris. Polaris actually has the ability to give you parts availability over on the invoice, but it doesn't actually give you the capability yet to place orders. They don't have that done yet. So there's a varied level of functionality here depending on what vendor we're looking at. But there are, you know, some huge advantages for those that are using Tucker Rocky and Western Power Sports. Parts Unlimited does not have any level of integration. They have no APIs. I do not know if they ever plan to have any APIs, but they're kind of the stepchild in, this respect. But Tucker and Western are definitely worth taking a look at. If I'm being told that this is fixed, so let's see how reliable our information is. So we'll just pick one of these items here, and then I'm going to hit availability, and it's not very good information. Let me tell him. Do what? Nah, it shouldn't matter. It's something else.
Yeah.
Well, it really isn't a big deal anyway. When you guys do it on your side, this stuff works. We were tweaking. Western Power Sports updated their API, and we just got through changing all of that stuff to work with it. So if you guys do it on your side, you're gonna get results back like you should. But basically, it's the same screen, but up here at the top, it will actually give you warehouse information and, you know, other details about that part that we've pulled in from whoever the supplier is. So it's some pretty good functionality in a gist. That's, you know, what it's all about. If you go over here to the Train Me section and go down to interface setup, you'll notice there's videos in here for how to set up the, you know, the different ones. So, you know, you've got Easy Link is another one, but they're not nearly this sophisticated. But you've got Western Power Sports and Tucker Rocky. So there's videos in here about how to set those up. If you're using BRP and or Polaris, they're already or should already be set up just by you going in and putting in your dealer information and password and stuff. That is all that's required for them. And most of you should probably already have that done, but they do give you the parts availability over on the invoice as well. So in a nutshell, that's all I wanted to cover is just some of those processes. We are going to try to start doing more of these webcasts in the future. We're trying to get ourselves on a schedule where we can start doing them at least every couple weeks. So look for more of these things coming. And if anybody's got any questions or anything, just email your support rep or is anybody, I don't know if there's any. How do I, okay, here's, and how to use it. Okay, so we got which vendors, and so the vendors are going to be right now Tucker Rocky, Western Power Sports, Polaris, and BRP. Those are the four major ones that have interfaces like this. There are a few other vendors that are working on stuff, but right now those are the only four that or have something that's actually functional. Will the system mark items that are back ordered? It depends on the vendor. There are different levels of integration. I believe on Western Power Sports and Tucker Rocky, though, they do mark the back order information, so it'll automatically get filled in for you. Can you mark items back order or will it do that? Yeah, again, it depends on the vendor. The BRP and Polaris don't have the ability to automatically do that yet. Hopefully they'll get to something like that. Can you place an order on hold? I'm not real sure about the place an order on hold. I don't really know what you mean by placing an order on hold. Yeah, well, there is one thing that I do want to mention is Tucker Rocky and Western Power Sports both, I believe, when you log into your portal for them, you have the ability to tell the system whether you want to have this API order automatically go in as an order or whether you want to have it come in for review, which is where you click the link in Lizzy, but then you still have to log into the web portal to review and actually submit the order. So you do have the ability to set that stuff. That's something you would do inside of their portal, though. It doesn't have anything to do with Lizzy. So if that's kind of what you're talking about, then that would be how you would do that. And then the last question is, Western had the option to place order on hold. Yeah, and that is kind of what we just covered. So yeah, you do have the ability to tell the portal that once that API order comes in that you want to review it, and then it'll hold it for you until you actually go in and do that. So does anybody else have any questions about this? I'll give y'all a minute or so to put anything in if you do. And so we don't seem to have any more questions, so we'll go ahead and lock this off. In the future, these webinars that we do, we're going to try to keep them to 15 minutes or so because we don't want to take up a whole lot of your time. We just kind of want to breeze through and introduce you guys to some parts of Lizzy that we think you might be missing. So look for more emails to come on future dates and topics, and we will be in touch. And if we don't talk to y'all, have a good Christmas.